It was a huge change programme for the Trust, involved 2,000 staff over 50 sites. The Trust saw this as an opportunity to look at clinical practice at the same time, and so we were implementing the system to support clinicians, looking particularly at standardising processes and making sure that information was accessible and available, and consequently also reportable from there. It's crucial to how we work across the Trust now. It's because it's the patient's primary record. All of our reporting, nearly all of our reporting, comes from it, and it's central to the business as well as the client aspects of the Trust. The major benefit for clinicians has been the access of information, and the fact that clinicians, for instance, on a Monday morning after having a weekend off, can see straight away what's happened to their clients over the weekend. And on the converse side of that, if a client appears in A&E, the doctors there can see straight away what the crisis plan is, what the care plan is, when they were last seen. Whereas prior to Rio, it would have been in a set of notes that was in a locked office, perhaps the other side of the borough. One of the big benefits for us has been the audit trail. Although people potentially have access to more information, that is all audited now, whereas before with paper records, nobody had any idea who was looking at those records. The things that BT have done well is a very structured project management, which in fact at the beginning was very difficult for us, in that we weren't particularly used to running a project in quite such a structured way. And certainly from my own point of view, as a new project manager, everything was new for us. But that meant that the BT structure helped us to get there, although at times it felt very difficult to get there. It certainly was what's supporting us at the same time. The difficulty is that there are three parties to it, and the London programme and BT and the Trusts, and trying to actually achieve the same end goal from very different directions. The most important thing, I guess, for the Trusts and BT is that they spend a lot of time understanding what each other is required to do and how that's going to happen. We have a very good relationship with BT now, and we've had different location deployment managers. The first time the manager was very experienced at project management, which really supported me and helped us to get through the project. And this time with a new deployment manager, he has more of an understanding of exactly what's required, and I think that's coming from BT. As well, and that it's very clear that they know what mental health trusts do. Most important to have the right people doing the job, and getting BT together with the Trust and working together. After all, we're all trying to achieve the same thing. I think the most inspiring thing for me has been the major changes that some of the clinicians have thought about, that where they can use Rio to support what they're doing, and they're working differently because of it. For instance, we have clinicians who are running care reviews with their clients, and they're making sure that they have Rio projected on the wall so all the clinicians can see exactly what's going on. The client is sitting there, and the carer, perhaps, they can all see exactly what's in the care plan and how it's being amended and changed for the client. And that couldn't have been done on paper records before. We'd also got other versions coming on over the next few years. And as a Trust, we've looked ahead and decided that we need to make sure we've got people in post to carry out some of that work, but also making sure that we're very closely working with the clinical processes, not just about IT.